Good folks, after these practices, you can run down to the paddocks and check out the drivers, work on their car, see them live, see those drivers, and get some pictures, all kinds of good stuff down in the paddocks.
Thank you. so soft and sharp, but the other crew guys are too light in the draw, so it's the crew round the others. Scott, yeah, down to turn one. This is going to be interesting. First tarmac braking time we've had this year. The dust complicates things in terms of how much grip there is. Now, Scott goes to the standard lap. He's going to hit the gap jump now. This is around 60 miles an hour. And you can't overhit it, Jared. So before, we've been able to overhit it and not worry. But here, because of that sweeping left hand, you've got to get the car on the ground. And then there's a big transition left and right and over the Zip Recruiter jump.
Predictions here, Coley, call it.
My prediction's pain. Doran had to kick the clutch at the start there, so his RPM wasn't high enough. The car bobbed, and now he's behind. So, Liam, I wonder if he'll go Joker straight away. Doesn't he follow Steve? He's almost alongside him up to the gap jump over for the first time. Doran is brilliant at the sideways stuff, and he loves this section here. The long left and the right, he'll flick the car back the other way, but actually Arpin's compromising his line there. So, I'm kind of surprised he didn't go Joker straight away.
Yeah. And...
on his face. Bigham trying to go around the outside, drops the wheel just out wide. Is Cabot going to take the speed round and go Joker? Doesn't he go standard lap as well?
Yeah, I'll tell you what, the butcher box vehicle, the tri rifle of Cabot Bigham, side by side over the jump, a great execution. Again, seeing them go over, I can't wait for tomorrow, the main, but regardless, this is awesome. Really good start by both of them. Notably, Cabot Bigham has had a tough year. He's had a tough go in Utah. Then he...
right, drops back immediately, so now he's going to have to do this on lap time. Looking this morning, where was Kevin? Kevin Hansen was P2, and of course McConnell didn't make it out, so McConnell's short on track time. And I actually went and spoke to the team. When they were warming the car up, they broke the bolts that bolt the transmission to the engine. Very strange on the road to the wheel. Two of the bolts had sheared off, and they had to get that sorted. It's not a big job. It's a really unusual thing to break. But so he's missing track time, and he's just dropped. As he comes in, he's looking to the inside line. He wasn't quite close enough, but that's the you can see there as Kevin moved out wide immediately, Jared, to try to get the inside line on Robin on the exit. He wasn't close enough, but as soon as you know you've lost the start, you might as well get the line right for turn one.
All right, let's take a look right the line. So he's taking that Joker lap. He's looking quick, he's looking fierce.
You're going to be very destiny.
Pastrana, there he is over the zip revolution, pushing so